In vitro fertilization is a fertility treatment by which the egg and the sperm are fused together in a laboratory. The resulting embryo is then transferred to the mother's uterus. The egg-sperm binding can be done in two different ways, either through conventional IVF or intracytoplasmic sperm injection or ICSI. When done by conventional IVF, both gametes are placed in a small petri dish so that the sperm is able to penetrate the egg cell by itself, thereby creating an embryo. With ICSI, the union between the sperm and the oocyte is induced manually, which makes the process easier. The following are the steps followed in IVF procedures. 1. Controlled ovarian stimulation. Fertility medications are injected intravenously to trigger egg production and maturation. This allows for ovulation to be controlled, thereby obtaining multiple eggs. It takes around 8 to 10 days. Throughout that period, the woman is monitored by ultrasound scan and blood test on a regular basis. 2. Ovum pickup. Surgery is necessary to aspirate the follicular fluid contained within the ovarian follicles, with the purpose of retrieving all the mature eggs before natural ovulation takes place. 3. Sperm collection. Semen samples are obtained through ejaculation. Then, the sperm is washed by means of sperm capacitation before selecting the sperms with the best quality. If no sperms were obtained, there exist other methods to obtain sperm cells, such as epididymal aspiration or testicular biopsy. 4. Insemination. It's the moment when the egg and the sperm are put in contact. 5. Embryo culture. Once fertilized, the egg is incubated in the laboratory, where it goes through two phases. First, zygote and then embryo. At this stage, the embryos are cultured before transferring back to the uterus or freezing them for future cycles. 6. Embryo transfer. The embryo or embryos with the highest quality are transferred to the mother's uterus. 7. Embryo vitrification. Unused viable embryos are frozen by means of a technique called embryo vitrification so that they can be used in future cycles. After the embryo transfer, women rest for no longer than 15 minutes. Then they can come back home and continue with their normal lifestyle. Pregnancy tests can be taken within 15 days to check whether IVF has been successful and a pregnancy has been achieved. The success rate of in vitro fertilization reached almost 40% in women under 35 years old. Given that the chances of getting pregnant diminish over time, the IVF rate in women older than 40 ranges from 10 to 15%. Even though it is a safe technique which has allowed a large number of couples to have a baby, the following are the potential risks associated with IVF. Ovarian hyperstimulation syndrome, due to an excessive stimulation of the ovaries. Multiple pregnancy, a risk which increases with multiple embryo transfers. Miscarriage. Ectopic pregnancy, which occurs when the embryo attaches to a place other than the uterine lining. IVF is a basic assisted reproductive technology. The first IVF child, better known as test tube baby, was born in 1978. And ever since that moment, a great number of patients with fertility problems have been able to become parents thanks to it.